Before starting each treatment, I would assess the patient for any changes in their condition, as well as vital signs. If the blood pressure is too low, I would not start treatment right away. So pre-treatment assessment is essential to ensuring the patient does not go unconscious or experience symptoms during treatment. Are you a new nursing graduate exploring your career option? Dive into the world of hemodialysis nursing with me. With almost 10 years of experience in dialysis, I'm here to guide you through the realities and rewards of this specialized field. This video is your all-access pass to the secrets they don't tell you about hemodialysis nursing. Prepare to be both informed and inspired about your potential future in this dynamic and fulfilling profession. Let's embark on this journey together. Hemodialysis can be shortened to dialysis, which is a specialized and a rewarding field that gears towards patients with kidney disease. As dialysis nurses, we provide dialysis treatments to these patients, which plays a crucial role in extending their lives. Patients with kidney diseases have kidneys that are no longer performing the essential function, such as filtering waste and excess fluids from the blood. Dialysis treatments play the role of the kidneys, and it is our job as dialysis nurses to understand how to provide the essential dialysis treatment by setting up the machine, giving patient education, proper assessment, and so much more. We will explore the role and responsibilities, what a day of being an outpatient hemodialysis nurse is like, and you can decide if this is the field that is meant for you. So, role and responsibilities. You're not providing patient care all by yourself as a hemodialysis nurse. We work closely with nephrologists, patient care technicians, social workers, dietitian, clinical managers, biomedical engineering, and more. Everyone's primary goal is to ensure that the patient is receiving the best dialysis treatment possible. Preparation. A dialysis nurse responsibility starts with dialysis preparation. I check the schedule to see where in the unit I am assigned to, which patients, and the technician that I am responsible for. In the state of New Jersey, my ratio was 1 staff member to 3 patients. The nurse is responsible for up to 9 patients overall. So I could be responsible for 2 technicians as well as my own patient, which could total 9 patients. Sometimes I would be assigned to 1 or even 0 patients, but I still have to be responsible for the care of my technician's patients, which would lead me about like 6 patients total. To clarify, when I say I am providing care for my technician's patient as well as my own, this means that I am responsible for setting up and completing the treatment of my very own assigned patient on top of ensuring my technician's patient's treatment also goes smoothly, get assessed upon admission and discharge, and get their ordered medication. All equipment must be sterile. I would set up the dialysis machine with the proper equipment, punch in my patient's orders on the machine, and get the chair ready with the needle, gauze, medical tape, and medication. Preparation includes drawing up pre-treatment medication for each patient as ordered, such as heparin. So on to assessment. So the patients are arriving into the unit and they sit at their designated chair assignment. They can't just switch chairs as desired because their specialized orders have been set on the machine for them. And these patients usually understand that. Each of them has a scheduled time, so I start each treatment based on the chair time. Patient A would be scheduled at 5 a.m., patient B 5:15, and patient C at 5:30 in the morning. Before starting each treatment, I would assess the patient for any changes in their condition, as well as vital signs. If the blood pressure is too low, I would not start treatment right away. So pre-treatment assessment is essential to ensuring the patient does not go unconscious or experience symptoms during treatment. The patient's vascular access site must be evaluated for potential signs of complications or infection. The vascular access site could be in a fistula, graft, or catheter. If the fistula or graft does not have any bruises or thrills noted during assessment, the patient unfortunately cannot receive dialysis treatment and must be sent to interventional radiology to get a procedure done to remove clots and then get rescheduled for dialysis treatment at a later time. After putting in the vital signs and necessary information into the machine, I get a second signature from another nurse or technician confirming that the correct dialysis orders have been placed on this machine to this correct patient. This prevents the incorrect dialysis orders from being given to the patient. Administering hemodialysis treatment. During the treatment, blood is removed from the patient's body and gets filtered through the artificial kidney on the machine, which is known as the dialyzer. Filtered blood is then returned to the patient. Treatment time can average between 3 hours to even 6 hours, but the most common time is typically 3 to 4 hours to treatment. Based on patient responses to the treatment parameters may get adjusted. So, you've reached the midpoint. How are you keeping up with all of this captivating information about hemodialysis nursing? It's a lot to absorb, but remember, every bit of knowledge brings you closer to mastering this incredible field. If you're finding this video helpful and you're excited to gain more insider knowledge and tips, don't forget to hit that red subscribe button. Your support helps us bring even more valuable content your way. So, ready to keep going? There's plenty more insight and advice ahead, so stay tuned, keep learning, and let's continue to explore the dynamic world of hemodialysis nursing together. You're doing great, so let's dive right back in. Medication administration. Some patients may receive medications that are prescribed by the nephrologist and others may not need medication at all. The majority of medications are injected into the machine and do not need to be directly injected into the patient. This can be antibiotic, iron medication, hectorol, and epogen. Of course, if this is the patient's first time receiving medication, the nurse must assess the patient's response within the first 15 to 30 minutes of receiving the medication or potential allergic reaction. There are some PRN medication that can be given to the patient, such as Tylenol and Benadryl. Patient education. Educating patients and their families is essentially an ongoing on a daily basis. Patients must be educated on their dietary restrictions, such as limiting high sodium and high potassium intake. Fluid intake must be restricted as well. The point of dialysis is to remove waste and fluid. If there is too much fluid to remove at once, the patient can become symptomatic or even go unresponsive. There's a maximum amount that can be removed from each patient, and it's calculated based on their weight and their treatment orders. Patients are also educated on medication compliance as well as treatment compliance. Majority of patients must get dialysis treatment 3 times a week. Emotional support. Many of these patients see you more than their own family and friends. Dialysis clinics become their second home, and they really trust you with their lives. We become their emotional support as they navigate through this new chapter of their life and play such an important role in their lives. It is highly stressful, scary, and these patients may sit here through their treatment, unable to leave their chairs for hours 3 times a week. And during that time, all they have is us. Post-dialysis assessment. After treatment has been completed, the technician or the nurse removes the needles from the patient and must ensure that the bleeding has stopped prior to leaving the unit by applying pressure. Patients that are alert and oriented can apply pressure to their own needle site. Vital signs are taken, and then the nurse will assess each patient to ensure that they are in stable condition prior to leaving the unit. Dialysis turnover. In my earlier example, I stated I had 9 patients, which is the ratio in the state of New Jersey. I haven't worked in dialysis in a while, so this can always change. So this is just the first shift. Our team is responsible for getting these 9 patients to come in, complete their treatment, get them out the door, clean the machines and chairs, prep the machine, and then get the next 9 patients in on their dialysis scheduled treatment time. It is so important to follow the schedule because these patients could miss their rides or be late to work. We do our best within our power to follow these times. Some units have 3 shifts, so that means there are 2 turnover. Other units have 4 shifts, which means that there are 3 turnovers. The turnovers are the most challenging part of the job because you're getting the patients in and out with a very tight constraint. In an ideal world, it is easy to follow the patient's scheduled time. Unfortunately, you may have a cold, a patient who won't stop bleeding, symptomatic patient that should not be discharged to home yet, or a patient who came to treatment really late. A lot of factors come into play that can make turnovers challenging. Shift handoff. My clinic had 4 shifts, so the staff was split into the morning and evening shift with 10 working hours. The morning shift would provide a shift handoff if one of their patients was extremely late, or if a patient had to be rescheduled to the evening shift. An example of this scenario happening would be a patient's axis not working, having to go to interventional radiology, and then getting rescheduled to receive dialysis treatment in the evening. The morning nurse should provide all of this information during shift handoff. Educational requirement. To become a hemodialysis nurse, you first must become a nurse. You can have an associate degree in nursing or a Bachelor of Science in nursing. Of course, you must pass the NCLEX-RN exam and become a licensed registered nurse. The majority of dialysis units prefer nurses to have experience in general nursing. However, this is where I started out as a new grad. This is where I trained a lot of new graduates who came in with zero experience. What I loved about this job was that it provided several months of training and education before I could just go out and confidently set up the machines and complete treatments for these patients. Companies such as DaVita and Fresenius, they have amazing programs for these nurses who are just starting out in the dialysis field. Working conditions. This really varies from unit to unit. The most common hours are 14-hour shift, 3 times a week. I want to say it would be ideally 12 hours because that's what it is set up for, but I arrive at 4:45 in the morning to set up the machines and then get the patient ready to start their 5:30 a.m. treatment. If the clinic is a 3-shift clinic, then the last patient would finish between 6 to 7 and then I would be done by 6:30 to 7:30. It also depends when the last patient's ride finally arrives. I do love the flexibility of dialysis. You can choose your shift and you almost always have your Sundays off, unless it's a holiday week. My favorite hour was when I worked on a Monday and Wednesday from 4:45 a.m. until midnight. That would cover nearly 40 hours for the week. Then I would be off from Thursday all the way to Tuesday without having to take paid time off. Then I would come back and work Wednesday to Saturday. 10-hour shifts or 2 20-hour shifts, either or. I love the flexibility and being able to travel during my long weekends. And I traveled a lot. Inpatient hemodialysis nursing. Acute or inpatient hemodialysis nurses have different unstable hours. It is a very different workflow, and there's a lot more to it when it comes to dealing with unstable patients that are hospitalized. The focus is to provide immediate care and support during their patient's stay. Sometimes the patients require treatment at 2 in the morning, so the on-call nurse may have to show up to administer emergency dialysis treatment. The shifts can be short, with just a few patients to provide care for, or it can be very long with many patients to provide care for. It is an erratic schedule because it depends on the hospitalization of the patients with kidney failure that requires dialysis. Inpatient dialysis nurses do not have the stress of handling 9 patients at a time, back to back, and dealing with turnover. They provide care for 4 to 5 patients in their unit with 1 or 2 other nurses or patient care technician. Or they will go to a patient's room in the hospital, such as the ICU, and provide dialysis treatment directly in the room. They would wheel the machine into the room with the equipment, then set up and complete the entire treatment in the room. Nurses prefer this because they can provide care at their pace without the stress and challenges of outpatient dialysis turnover. Impact on patients' lives. As a hemodialysis nurse, we play a vital role in keeping the patient's quality of life as they navigate their lives with kidney disease. We make such a huge difference that goes deeper than just providing them treatments. We are here to maintain their dignity and independence. It was a very rewarding career choice for me. I absolutely love seeing the same patient 3 times a week. I got to know them and become a part of their lives. I loved the stability of knowing what my schedule was going to be like and who I was providing care for. If you are considering a career in hemodialysis nursing and you are nervous about embarking towards a career you have little knowledge, don't be. It is very friendly towards nursing graduates, especially that you will not be providing care for patients until you have completed the hemodialysis course. Through specialized education, providing compassionate and quality patient care, you can make a difference in a patient's life with kidney failure. And that's a wrap on our thrilling exploration into the world of hemodialysis nursing, where every day is a mission to make a difference. Feeling empowered and ready to be a superhero in scrubs, the adventure doesn't end here. For more insider secrets and essential skills, check out our next video, where we continue to dive into the fascinating realms of nursing. Don't forget to like, share, and hit that red subscribe button. It's your pass to a wealth of knowledge and the latest update in nursing expertise. So keep up the exceptional work in your studies. Each step you take is a leap towards your dream of becoming a skilled and compassionate nurse. Stay focused, stay inspired, and remember, your journey to greatness is just beginning. See you in the next video, and until then, keep saving lives and follow your dreams.